lock off a descender so that it's safe to remove both hands without the risk of sliding down the rope. This practice is a standard part of crossing rebelays or performing changeovers, and is often necessary when rigging. One of the advantages of bobbins over other types of descenders is the ease and speed of locking off and the small amount of rope that is required. You can perform what is called a soft lock by simply taking the tail of the rope and dropping it between the tensioned rope and the bobbin. This is not a reliable or fail-safe way of locking off the descender, and in most situations the brake hand should not be removed from the rope. Perhaps the only exception is when you are rappelling into the loop of a rebelay. In this case, you can do a soft lock and pull yourself over to the anchor because you're within just a few feet of the bottom of the loop if the soft lock accidentally releases. A hard lock-off, or full lock-off, allows you to safely remove both hands from the rope. There are a couple of ways of doing this depending on what type of braking carabiner is being used. With the Freno and Raumer handy, a so-called Swiss lock is possible, where you begin with a single wrap of the rope over the top of the bobbin, then clip the rope back into the brake spur a second time, and wrap it over the top of the bobbin again. This is a very fast method and requires very little rope. The other method that works with any type of braking carabiner is to begin with a soft lock, then pass a bite of rope through the connection carabiner and take the bite up and over the top of the bobbin and cinch it tight. The new handle design makes it less likely that it may get bumped or squeezed, causing an accidental release of the brake. The new stop also no longer has a hole in the lower bobbin for locking out the brake mechanism, although this was a function that was rarely used by most cavers. Another big change is that now both bobbins are made from stainless steel. The old stop had a steel insert on the upper aluminum bobbin to mitigate wear, but now the entire upper bobbin is stainless. Neither of the bobbins on the new stop are removable or replaceable. The bolt and nut configuration has been replaced by riveted pins. This means that once one of the bobbins wears through, then the device will need to be replaced. Neither the upper nor lower bobbin appears to be solid stainless steel, and while stainless will wear much slower than aluminum, only time will tell what these changes will mean to the lifetime of the device. The oval slot on the lower side plate has been enlarged to allow the newly designed Freno Z carabiner to rotate through it. The new stop weighs 339 grams, which is only 13 grams, or 4%, heavier than the old version. But if you use it with the new Freno Z, which is 11 grams, is now being marketed primarily for sport rather than professional use. The reduction in recommended rope diameter may be more a reflection of this shift away from rope access and rescue use than a change in the performance of the device itself. It was always difficult to use the stop on ropes over 11 millimeters in diameter, and it was always practical to use it on ropes below 9 millimeters. The final version of the new stop has not been released yet, but the prototype is missing the EN341 Type A certification needed by rescue professionals. From a very brief time using the new stop, I am left with a few impressions. The handle now points down rather than up when carrying it on a gear loop, and because the handle folds, the overall length of the stop is now shorter. This makes it less likely to catch on things when traveling through horizontal cave. The shape of the bobbins has changed, and the path the rope takes is slightly different. I haven't had a chance to test it on a wide variety of rope diameters or in various wet or muddy caving conditions, but my first impression is that the brake engages a little more positively and releases more easily. Cavers have often joked that the device should be called the Petzl Slow because the brake doesn't always fully engage. Other cavers have often complained that constant pressure on the handle to get the brake to release, in especially deep vertical caves, causes significant fatigue and pain to the left hand. I believe the new design improves both these issues. Although the new Petzl Stop won't be available commercially for a few months, you'll almost certainly be able to get one from the usual caving vendors, including OnRope One, Intermountain Outfitters, or Car Sports. Please note that this review was not sponsored or